Hey guys, today I'm bringing you a video with me driving the VK4502, and both games are with Dimi to Dimi, and he's driving a Pershing in this game and the Glacial in the next game. Now, this was while I was still grinding for the mouse, and I go up the stairs here, but when I realize that there's actually no one there, I'm just gonna cap the base. And this little beastie is actually a tank that I really enjoyed grinding, unlike the tier 9, which I don't really much like at all. But then I've noticed that I'm just not really good with tanks that have rear mounted turrets. But anyway, I stand here and I start shooting people and just cap another base while I'm at it. Because, well, it's supremacy, so capping bases is always a good thing. And to be fair, these two games aren't actually about me reviewing this tank. I mean, of course, I'll mention it a little and everything, but it's more about the fact that when you have the right tune mate, you can do so much and things can work out so well. And it doesn't have anything to do with stats, to be honest. If you have the right dynamic between a tune, you can do things that alone you wouldn't be able to do. And of course, that's a bit of a duh. Of course you can't do things on your own that you can do in a tune because you're actually two people. But when you have the right dynamic, you can accomplish a heck lot, and if you have the wrong dynamic, a tune can actually work against you. Now, I do get shot as I go down, I bounce another shot, and then I just decide to be a bit aggressive, but still use cover, and go here instead of right in their faces straight away. Now, this guy peeks out, he actually looks at me, but he doesn't shoot, and I get one into him, and when he peeks out again, he bounces. And, well, the Leeuwe decides to come, but I actually hit the ground instead of the Leeuwe, which doesn't really help matters. And in the meantime, my platoon mate has driven down as well, so I know that he's to the left of me doing his thing. And I decide to push left as well to, well, help him, and to take care of the IS-3 that has been so annoying. And this is generally just always something I like doing when I'm in tune, like a sort of pincer movement, because it's impossible for an enemy to shoot two people at the same time. Now, I'm taking his attention away from my teammate, and I can shoot him and kill him before he lands his next shot. Now, this guy bounces on me, and Dimi actually gets the shot in as well, and when he peeks out again, I kill him off. So now I have the option to either push or to cap another base, and I decide to push first and then cap, but Dimi already kills him, so then I just pull back into the base, because they're already capping base B, they already capped base A again. So we do need bases just in case, and it's 3 versus 2. So yeah, you never know what will happen. Now, Dimi and my last remaining teammate are heading towards the base B, and I decide to go on after them. This guy just stands here while Dimi has already gone up, and that means that the prototype isn't likely to get any shots in, because I don't think he can shoot up high like that. And that means that Dimi can use some help, so I rush in after him as fast as the tank will allow. And considering that it is a heavy, it's not exactly meant to be very fast. But Dimi is trolling the LTTB, and I get another shot in, and then Dimi kills him off. So then we win the game, because that's the last of it, and I bump into Dimi, and we wait for the battle to finish. And the fun thing about this battle is that when the results load in, I actually have a first class. And I'm like, ah, that's decent. I have more XP than Dimi, but Dimi aced his tank. So that was actually something that I found pretty funny. And the next battle, he's driving the Glacial, which is very pretty, but I'm not that big a fan of the tank. And I'm still driving the VK. And I go right on this map, because generally I find that on this side of the map the positioning is better, and you can just generally dominate more of the map and do more. By the time I got there, one of my teammates is already dead, and I peek over to get a shot in, but as I do that, I also get shot myself, so I know I need to pull back a little bit just to be on the safe side. So while I know that I can't really shoot there without endangering myself, I decide to peek over here, and I switch to Primo to shoot the guy. I already bounce a shot, so I pull back before I get shot again, but then I decide to be pig-headed, and I peek over the edge anyway to shoot, and I lose quite a bit of health. But I do get a shot in, except that it doesn't do any damage, because it actually bounces. And then I decide, okay, let's focus on the other side again and see if I can keep any of my teammates alive. Because this tank, even though it can be Crytrol, it doesn't really have the armor of a mouse or anything like that, so taking chances with this, especially in this situation, can be quite tricky. But I decide to peek over just a little bit anyway, but I don't actually have the gun depression. So I peek on further, luckily I bounce, I get a shot in, and then I pull back a little bit again because I know I need to be careful. And I hope to get another shot in, especially HE, because, well, ass and everything. And I do get that, but then I get shot again. And this guy misses by a mile, luckily, so I'm still relative good on HP. Only, we now have one teammate left, and the enemy team has six of them left, which generally is not really a good thing. So at this point in time, I'm fairly sure that I will be doomed. But I know that I need to push now together with my teammate, because if we don't, we will get rushed by everyone at once, and that means for sure that we will lose. So I peek on over here, get a shot in, and I know that he can finish him off if he reloads in time. But if he doesn't, I'll shoot first and then I'll kill him. But he does kill him first, and I decide to peek over the edge here to see if whom we can meet. Now this guy is there, and I shoot, pull back. Basically what I need to do is let Dimi take the shots, because, well, he's a lot better armored than I am, and I can do some peek-a-booming while he takes the brunt of the hits. But now we know that with us being the only ones here, we will likely get pincered, so we need to be very careful, and I do get shot in the ass right away. I get a shot in, and I decide to turn that way, because that's a very easy target for me to shoot. So we basically change positions so I can get some kills in. Now I HE the IS to death, which is not the target that I was looking for, but it helps, so. Then this guy bounces on me, and he was my original target. I kill him, and there's another one shot behind him, but at the same time I have a KV-3 coming up behind me. So I need to be careful with that, because he can possibly do quite a bit of hurt. Luckily he doesn't have a really big gun, or at least he doesn't do very much damage. So I cut some shots in and I call for help, because I know that I will need help dealing with this guy. Now, Dimi has just taken care of the guy that he was facing. I'm turning around so we can together face the KV-3 and the TD that's still back there as well. Now, we kill that guy off, which is just leaving the enemy TD. And by now my heart is just racing, because I never thought that we would be able to pull this off. And technically speaking, we could still lose, but chances are pretty small when it's now just one guy. And we're both of us still alive. So we manage it. Dimi still has more than half of his health left. And we carry that game like a boss. I get a first class, do a whooping amount of damage, have very little credits left, and we just carry together like no tomorrow. So I'm really happy with this game. It was epic. And I love games like this in general. Together with your teammate, you can do so much, and it can be just so much fun and so intense at the same time. And I'll be seeing you guys the next time again.